All right, welcome back to a new place, NBA 2K18. I just signed with Nike. They gave me a pretty sweet deal, and that's what I wanted to do to begin with. So let's see who else we got. Just got an email from D'Angelo Russell here. Congrats on joining the Nike team. You made the right call there. Thanks, D. Russ. Man, word gets quick. They already knew already, man. All right, I'm going to go ahead and do some practice stuff, and then we're going to get into a game. We'll see you then.
And we'll see DJ on the court tonight. And if you follow shoe trends, then you'll know he just signed a huge shoe contract. What does that mean for a player like DJ?
You know, getting a shoe contract is a sign that you made it to the big time. They don't give contracts out to nobody, Ernie.
And not only that, he's got the shoe contract from the – shoe contractors, shoe contract. You know what I mean? Like, the people who watch you get shoe contracts, they want to give them a shoe contract. Unbelievable.
What size shoe do you wear?
All right. Well, there you go.
Did you have a shoe contract?
Yeah.
Him signing with Nike is a big deal. Let's go and get into the game.
Hey, man, come on, Jug, you can't be standing behind me like that, bro. Almost gave me a heart attack.
I see you listening to that new little Uzi Vert, though.
Yeah, that's on my mix, man. It's fire.
Oh, you know I have a couple playlists on SoundCloud, right?
Oh, for real?
You should use them in your mixes, maybe.
Oh, you use SoundCloud? Yeah, man, I'm thinking about moving my vinyls to digital.
Oh, yeah. You old school, huh?
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's how I actually learned, too. You ever seen that movie Juice? My fourth cousin's friend arranged a scratch pattern for that one scene.
Oh, what?
Yeah, man, DJing's been in my blood, you know? But that site's cool too, you know? You might need Serato. I'll hook you up. When are you gonna be DJing next, man?
You know, man, I'm not sure, but it'll probably be during the off season and at a spot where they don't allow 18-year-olds.
So. All right, man, whatever, right. That's cool.
Yeah.
Hey, I gotta get back to work, but if you see Shammy, tell him he owes me $5, okay?
All right, I will, Jeff.
All right.
Shouldn't you be somewhere working, man? Come work. Hey, what's was Jug doing here, man?
I don't know, following me, apparently, but he says you owe him $5.
What? So. He said I owe him $5.
That's what the man said.
He still owed me from our bet last week, man.
Man, never pays up.
All right, there we go. And who we got? Paul George. Pretty sure seeing me before the Nike meeting is what's the deal, right? Of course. All right. Quit messing with me. All right, here we go. Taking on the Dallas Mavericks.
2K Sports checks in with our loyal viewers with the broadcast from Boston.
15-10, the Mavericks are
home of the Celtics. Sit back and enjoy this presentation of NBA basketball on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony, Chris Weber, and David Aldridge, Kevin Harlan. And we have a surprise guest, folks. There he is, the four-time All-NBA first-teamer. And with tip-off coming up.
Let's get in there. Let's go.
David, thank you as always. Shammy Wells, not the first player you would think of as a mentor, but, you know, it's worked out.
All right.
And Kevin, you've recently gotten a chance to do more TV. Your show Area 21 has been tremendous, and the critics love it. Talk about this chapter of your career.
Well, it was something that I wasn't planning on, Turner brought me a great concept, and it fit the mold of what any man cave is, and that's really what it is.
Yeah, win the first touch.
The fact that we can go in, watch games on multiple channels, see multiple games, articulate it, you know, get it from a perspective of a player, coming fresh out of this generation of players, giving understanding to this generation of players is very important because these players now are very different. Teaching these young players, still being mentors of these players, very important. And still loving this game. It's still a beautiful game. Man, the game is growing.
Get out
watching these kids do all types of different stuff, man. The creativity in our game now is so heightened. So, yeah, I'm having a bunch of fun, which is one thing I never forgot the piece of advice you've always told me, man. So you continue to enjoy what you do and
the show.
And I'm hoping that I'm making you proud today, Kay. I'm enjoying
I allowed the offensive move. I wasn't even down there yet.
Incredible ambassador to all of those things. The game, the fun of life. Right. You capture a lot of the fun of life.
I'm trying. I'm enjoying it.
There we go.
Hopefully it can show.
Now, look at Dallas's starting lineup. On the wings, Curry and Barnes. Dwight Powell is out there at Nerlens Noel. And it's Farrell in at the point. And Kevin, you played for some great coaches, but is there any coach you would have been interested to work with that just didn't get a chance to? Say, you know, Greg Popovich or Phil Jackson.
Mm. You know, those are great coaches. I've had very, very little time with those guys.
Maybe all-star games and things like that.
I have. You know, when you do all-star games, you let yourself go. You know, you open up yourself to try to, you know, be there and be present with the guys.
Yes.
Open up, you know, hey, what's up? What's been up with you? How's the year for y'all? Y'all playing well? We're going to beat y'all when we see y'all, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, you're very cordial. And, you know, you're not talking too much about X's and O's. But you do share perspectives. You do share, you know, philosophies. Pop is a great mind. I had a chance to sit with him a couple times. Phil's a great mind. Phil's is super deep and loves the philosophy of. I haven't had a lot of time with those guys. Doc Rivers, you know, shout out to Doc. And, you know, I know he doesn't get a lot for his philosophies, but he's very enriched with philosophies and styles and bringing teams together and trying to make sure that guys stay
connected,
stimulated. He would always tell us, and never get bored with the process.
Wow, that's so intriguing. Interesting to hear.
Who kicked?
Here's Curry. Last game out, 36 points for him. Powell with the screen. It's Curry with the drive. In the corner, Farrell. Kevin, it's been said that some guys hated to play against you. Is there someone you hated to play against for whatever reason?
No.
You enjoyed every gym?
I enjoyed every competitor because on the offensive side of the ball, I was always challenged when to use counters or what type of moves I was using. I took a lot of pride in having a variety of moves for different types of defenses. And each guy is going to bring out a different side of the offense in you. And then turning around and then being that defender and being able to guard the post player or the post or whatever the post player was or whatever. Rasheed Wallace was always a tough guard. Tim Duncan was always a tough guard. Zach Randolph was always a tough guard. Chris Webber, Dice, Karl Malone.
Great names.
And getting after it on the offensive glass and adding to that early total with the putback.
That's what I like to see. Really making a concentrated effort to pound the glass, feast on those second chance opportunities.
Puts it up from 15, and that one goes long.
I'll give him that shot again. He'll probably hit it. That's a good look.
Kevin, especially back in Minnesota, you have some Hall of Fame battles with a guy named Tim Duncan. Mm-hmm. Talk about what those games, matchups were like.
Timmy, man. Timmy's very crafty, man. Our battles used to just, especially as young guys, man. Young guys trying to establish themselves in a gritty league at the time, full of some older dominant names at the time. Michael Jordan, Olajuwon, Malone. You know, the time where the forward position was a very, very tough position. But Timmy was one of them ones, man. Used angles very well, was very long, had a lot of counters, very strong, and had an inner beast that people really didn't really talk about because you didn't really necessarily hear or see it. But, man, Timmy's one of the best, man. It's not by coincidence. He's one of the ones.
Powell with the screen. Curry kicks to Noel, and Noel throws it down.
Oh, he caught him in stride with the lead pass. Now, that was timely.
It's up with Nowitzki.
The Celtics have gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. The monster passes to Hayward. Picked him clean. And they're on the break. Farrell gets the bucket. Farrell's got his first basket of the night. And that replay brought to us by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. One of the more exciting plays in basketball.
Kevin, what a lot of fans don't get to see is all the work players do behind the scenes at home before games. A little bit about that, getting your body ready from the end of one game to play the next game. I mean, I've seen it, but you talk about it.
Yeah, the wellness starts right after you stop playing. The minute you come off the court, you're iced. You know, you got to do progressions where right after the game, you shower. Obviously, you got to get massages. You got to get some type of wellness on your legs just because you're running so much. People don't know that you have to lift weights. You know, when we was in Boston, we lift every other day. We had a strenuous strength program. Shout out to B-Doo. Brian Dew, who's our strength coach up there, never let us get a day off. And if you didn't lift weights, then we find you as a player.
Players find you.
Because it's important for you to come in here and be strong. We need everybody to be as strong as they can be. So you have to lift.
Yeah.
And then, actually, you know, you practice. But after practice, you have to put time into your own personal game.
Right, right. So much goes into it. It's amazing. And KG, so great to see you. It takes me back. It really does.
A lot of people don't know, man. We got real original ties, man.
Back to the 90, beginning.
95, man. My original man right here.
There he was, man. He was a thrill a minute. I'll tell you that.
Man.
A thrill a minute.
Now look at us. 21 years later, dog.
You know,
man, can you believe
we're still standing.
We are. They haven't caught on yet. Don't say anything.
When you played, we all know how intense you were, how much you cared. That, to me, was the thing that you cared so much about the product, about your team, about the game. But some people have said that maybe there was a streak of you that was mean is maybe not the right word, but you were overly aggressive. But I don't know how you could have played any differently.
I call it dialed in.
What?
You know, I like to think that if you're trying to accomplish something, then, you know, I only know one way to accomplish
it.
You go at it with everything you have.
Yes.
You go to dominate it and take it over. You don't go at something lightly.
Not at all.
And this game is full of talented elites. Night in, night out, you're playing someone that can typically go for 50 easy.
So true. On the floor for Dallas. On the wings, Curry and Barnes. Nerlens Noel is out there with Powell. And it's Farrell in at the point guard. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the monster in the last game against the Bucks was just phenomenal. He finished with 24 points, and that scoring outburst set a new season high for him in what became a great exhibition on his part. A fantastic effort for a guy who may just start making some waves around this league. Should be interesting to watch, Kevin.
Thanks, David. It was a performance that not many players are capable of.
I know I won't forget it for a while, and you have to think he'll keep it rolling here tonight. When you're that hot, it takes a while to cool down.
Yeah, he was special. But the biggest challenge for him tonight is that the defense will be ready for him. They saw what he did in the last game, just like the rest of us.
Four on the shot clock. A three from Barnes. Barnes with another miss. And Kev, you think of the great ones. You, Kobe, Jordan.
Timmy,
yeah, how about him? They worked harder than anybody else, Kevin.
And what you learn is that the similarity that, or the parallel that you all have is an inner animal that you never speak about. You know, we're all a little off.
Mm-hmm.
We're all a little dark. But that's what pushes you through pain. That's what pushes you through tough moments. When someone says you can't, when someone says this is not possible, this is unreal. No one's ever done that. That's the moment you're looking for. The moment someone told Kobe that he couldn't get over 50, 60, something Georgia couldn't do,
he was
driven in that. And if Phil wouldn't have stopped him, he probably would have reached 100 points.
He probably would have, yeah.
You know, he did. He did Will Chamberlain a favor. And that's just real. He was in that type of mode. We all share that passion. We all share that drive. And the ones that have that inner darkness, we all understand.
It's like a split personality.
It's almost like another level.
Yeah. Kevin, we've all seen the evolution of the perimeter-style offense. Do you think it'll ever go so far that we'll see the game come back to an inside-oriented offensive scheme?
I think right now that with pace being the way it is now, Kev, I don't see it necessarily going through or going back to playing through the post. Although, you have to have an alternative. I think that you just can't be all three-pointers and layups. I think you have to have a constant flow of inside-outside. I think it helps to have a post player. I think having a post player player or a true post player that can score and dominate the middle, opens up threes and opens up ball movement.
You played during the transition too, didn't you? From a grinded out type of game inside to spacing that we have now.
I did, and I'd like to say that, you know, Doc Rivers started the small ball, and you know, we were very, very keen on the small ball. So I think in today's game, you got to be able to shoot the three now and be able to handle the ball and put the ball on the floor and make decisions. So it shows that the game is transformed.
Regular season grind, 82 games in the regular season. In your opinion, is that the right amount of games for teams to play, or would you like to see the schedule shortened where there's more practice in between, more days of rest, more days to recuperate?
Man, look.
Get a big smile on your face.
For the old school, Kev, you know, 82 games is how you got to come through it. This is, listen.
It's a war, isn't
it? Listen, it is. And you know what? This is the tradition of it, man. This is what it is, bro. If you don't want to go through this and go through this hall and this road of this journey, then cool. Go to another league. They got shorter games. They got other rewards that you can, you know. This is the NBA. This is what it is. This is the grind of it. And ones that have come before you have done it, just like the ones that's after you is going to do it. This is what it is, bro.
This is it to Noel.
No.
And the basket time from the field. He's a healthy 4 for 6. Kevin, over the years, we've seen a number of super teams develop. And in the Warriors' case, it's not the big three, it's the big four. Is this a trend you see continuing? You did it in Boston.
Man, look.
You were the original big three.
It seems like it, ain't.
Yeah, right. You were the original big three.
You know what? It's like an innovative thing. Right? I didn't even know that we were doing that. Right, because LeBron come back and do what? LeBron goes to
Miami. He's the big three right down there.
And then what? Then it just starts morphing into these different things, right?
KD to Golden State.
Right. Oh, man. This is.
What do you think of it?
I think this is pretty much the norm. You know what? Listen, I think KD took a lot of heat for it, but when you really think about what he's doing, is that, I say 20 years from now, he sits back, he wants to talk to Steph, he's talking to Draymond, he's talking to Clay. These are all going to be three greats with him. These are, I'm just talking about those three guys. He's playing with three other greats. I'm sorry. If you had a chance to play with the other greats in the prime, Kev, you're going to do that. And if you don't, then something's wrong with you.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Marcus Morris comes in for Al Horford. And it's Tatum in for Brown.
And at the line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his stroke, it never wavers.
To the wing right side. Here's Tatum. And no good. And it's Dallas the other way. And Kevin, you look at the star players joining up today. At the end of the day, it's about winning.
The game is about winning. More importantly, it's about these bonds that you're able to establish. Those guys are going to be brothers forever. Now, I get the whole OKC, him leaving, right? But this is morphing into something else, and I think that this is going to be part of the norm. It is, man, and that's what you're in this for. You go to build these things. I don't know if I would have done it like that, but I understand it. I get it. He's playing with the other greats that's making the game more efficient for him, and it's working. But, yes, I see this being the norm in the league.
Here's Farrell. Here's Noel. That one misses. Excellent D there from the monster. Adding a lot of flavor to the mix, Kevin Garnett. Kevin, thanks for stepping by. Always a pleasure. Hope you join us again sometime.
Man, Kevin, it's always a pleasure, man. It's always great to see you, man. Anytime you need me, you holler at me, all right?
Future Hall of Famer and a terrific person, Kevin Garnett. What a treat it is, Greg. And KG with us always offers so much insight. Played the game for an amazing 21 seasons.
Yeah, you know, when he first entered the league, everybody was wowed by the athleticism. But what became more apparent really early on were the instincts for which he had for the game. And that's what he brings, I feel like, to the broadcast.
And two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot. And there's the foul against Dallas.
Well, the one thing you notice about the Celtics, they look for players with a chip on their shoulder. They want players with that inner fire, that love for competition.
And the first one drops. And you look up and down the Celtics roster, Chris, a lot of guys who play with a chip on their shoulder.
Well, that's how you build a culture. It rubs off on the other players. I mean, you have to find those guys, though. It's not something you can teach.
Celtics making a switch here. Rozier's checked in. And then for Dallas, Withy comes in for Dwight
Powell.
And Smith subbed in for Curry.
Another double-double. In the first.
Farrell kicks to Withy. Smith outside. There's a screen by Noel. Feeds it to Withy. The three ball. The putback. Great positioning on the putback. And the Mavericks lead by two.
Well, it's nice to have an option like him every time down the court.
To the inside. Stolen by Withy.
Oh, bad pass, man. It wasn't a bad call for a pass. It was just a bad pass.
Here's Farrell. Over Smart. And the shot no good. A bit short.
That's the board. Come on, that was my board. Of the activity level. Don't give me credit. All right, that's half. Double-double in the first half.
Hey, Kevin, fast start. Already have a double-double in the first half. So do you think the defense is going to start to focus on you more in the second?
If they do, then I'll just make sure to keep the ball hopping around. I mean, we have so many great players on this team that if you give one of us too much attention, the other four will just eat you alive. And, you know, if they want to focus on me the rest of the way, then by all means, you know, I'll invite it. But, you know, I know my teammates have my back.
You got it going. Maybe your teammates can pick you up in a second. Back to you guys.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start.
All right, 10 points, 11 rebounds, 3 assists, and a steal. Stop freeway out there and have the ball.
Okay. Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. One of the stories here, Harrison Barnes getting it done today.
Yeah, so far they haven't found an answer for him, a scoring machine here in that first half.
Oh, well, he's a tricky cover. He does a good job of sensing the defense, making the right move at the right time.
Hayward out there with Horford. Then there's Smart. Then there's the monster. And it's Irving in at the point. That's the group for Brad Stevens getting going here in the second half. Horford, no luck.
Just the presence of the D in the lane is enough to make him short arm that layup.
No one near Curry as he lets it go. Hands it from downtown. Curry's got 12.
All right, we're down by 7 all of a sudden.
The defense collapses inside. He shrewdly launches the transition three.
Here's Hayward. Mavericks with the rebound. Fresh from a win against the Nuggets.
Yeah, unfortunately for them, I thought the opponent's defense just never showed up.
Freaking way. No,
but I like that they attacked those weaknesses. They made him pay for a lackluster effort.
Oh, a nice tip in to salvage the points from that missed shot.
Yeah, those second chance points can add up. Celtics passing it around. Horford. They get it back. Here's the monster and the bucket counts. 3-point chance here.
Well, after failing to hit on their first three attempts to have, they finally got one to go there.
This will be his third free throw shot of the game.
And did he lay an egg at the stripe in their previous game? Couldn't get anything to drop.
Getting a little rough underneath there, man. I'm off. Oh,
Chris, there have been some great sixth men on the teams that you played with, but right now, who do you feel are some of the best of the bunch coming off the bench and in the NBA right now?
Well, two of my rookies, two guys I got to play with, Andre Iguodala, I think he's always going to be kind of that perennial top for sixth man of the year. He and another guy that was a rookie with him, and that's Lou Williams. He can just get buckets at any time that he needs to. And you look at a guy like a Patty Mills coming off the bench for the Spurs, and you don't have to necessarily do it with volume or with quantity, but it's also your quality of minutes, and I think that Patty Mills is someone that could definitely light it up in a flash. And these three guys, anytime you have them coming off the bench for you, you're going to have some firepower.
Now here's Smart. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Shot clock at 3. Busted. No good that time either.
Oh, how did I miss
this? This is turning into a slow start here in the second half. Seems like they left that offense in the locker room.
Come on,
guys. It just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Now a timeout called by Boston. This game coming after a loss against the Bucks.
Yeah, they gave up in that one. The defense constantly breaking down way too many times.
Yeah, I'm with you. Disgraceful performance and an issue that might be tricky to fix.
Celtics trail by 10. Irving passes to the monster. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. Horford kicks to Irving. Just 5 on the clock. The Celtics need to get a shot off. Inside. No good for the monster.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Can't find an open shot.
And stolen by Kyrie Irving. Goes up on the slam dunk by Irving.
Oh, look at that. Irving just leaked out wonderfully in transition. He's a remarkable decision maker in fast break situations.
And that replay brought to us by Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. One of the more exciting plays in basketball. Noel, a screen on Irving. Pass to Barnes. Clock at 4. Drops in the tray. Barnes has got 15. Hmm.
And you can see it. They're in a nice rhythm in terms of shooting. It's been that way the entire second half.
Yeah, they've come out of the break with an eye toward efficiency. One of the advantages they hold in this game.
Irving drives in. He used that pick to get in close.
You have to love it.
What happened?
Mavericks leading by 4.
Oh, let's sit down.
Now Curry, 12 points for him. Here's Withy. There's the pick. Matthews into the lane. Rebounded by the Celtics. The Monsters got 13 rebounds in the game. Class eating. To the middle. Hook shot on the way. It's rebounded by Dallas. They've led by as many as 11 points.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole because he is just not there offensively.
Smith dishes to Matthews. Whistle on the play. Bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
Smart's checked in for Boston. The Mavericks have shot 67% from the line tonight, going 4-6.
And taking a look at the numbers on the season, they've converted about 77% of those foul shots.
Kicks it to Tatum. Boston again missing.
Well executed, great rhythm. You've got to finish that one.
Yeah, coming off of a good pick, you want to get that one. He gets the separation he needs. I know he would love to have that one back.
They set the pick, dishes it to Smith. It's tipped. They retain possession.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
You can't get it, man.
Dallas with the ball. They're on a 17-7 run. And it's rare for rookies to come into the NBA ready at the defensive end. But you know what, C-Web? Jaylen Brown already more than solid.
Well, yeah. I mean, he has a great frame. He plays physical. He's in a great system.
Come on,
and
man.
He'll only get better with time.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
And Matthews kicks to measuring. Dallas moving it around. The dish to Matthews. From deep. The rebound by the Celtics.
As off the mark as he has been, they're a little lucky to be in front.
Tatum wide open. He fires one. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Tatum's got 5 points now this quarter.
Oh, what incredible precision. Brown cutting the D to pieces in his pass.
The shot by Curry. No good. Celtics trail by 4. To the right side. Lets it go from deep. They grab their own miss. The monster
off with the layup.
And out of rhythm offensively, but he continues to work at it.
I mean, truth is, if you play long enough, sometimes you're going to have a bad quarter, even a bad game. I doubt that this shakes his confidence.
What a battle for that rebound there. He did an outstanding job in getting position and hauling that one in.
A nice shot by Tatum.
And he has starting to turn it on now after that slow start.
The Mavericks shooting 43% from the floor. Curry against Brown. Curry with it. 12 points for him. There's the screen. Outside Matthews. And no good trying to get that one. It's still anybody's game as we reach the end of three. The Mavericks on top. All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. Fourth quarter should be good. Boston trailing. On the court for the Mavericks. Smith Jr. and Curry paired at the one and the two. Dwight Powell is out there with Matthews. And it's Rithy in at the pivot spot manning the middle.
Swingman Jaylen Brown trying to find his way in the league. Had a really good playoff last year. And he's kind of a renaissance man. Plays the guitar, studies foreign languages. He's the captain of his high school chess team. But he doesn't want none either. I'll get him a chance.
And Matthews gets it to go in on the assist by Smith.
They are just killing them on the interior.
The Celtics shooting 39% from the floor. Not their best. Now, here is Morris. D right on him. The feed to Smart. Down to five on the shot clock. Hits. Count that one from the Monster. The Monsters got the game tied up here for the Celtics.
Great move to get to the rim. I think they're going to take the aggressive approach down the stretch.
That's the right call. Make the defense get physical with you and pick up some fouls in the process.
And for the Mavericks, clearly the rebuild, Greg, has begun.
Yeah, but they made good use of their picks. They brought in more youth and signed their building blocks. Franchise isn't used to rebuilding, but they are approaching it, I think, the right way.
Irving's checked in for Jaylen Brown. The Mavericks also with a sub. Barnes, he's checked in for Seth Curry.
And he gives them the lead. Successful trip, despite the one miss.
Here's the Monster. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
The Celtics making major strides offensively. Back in 2014, one of the worst teams in the league. They've gotten better every season.
He's off on the first.
What the heck was that? Come on.
And the arrival of Al Horford surely has a lot to do with this Celtic offensive revival.
And now with Hayward, Kyrie Irving, and Tatum added, it'll be even better. At the same time, in a selfish style, sharing the basketball, a lot of drive and kick. They bury teams from the three-point line.
Nerlens Noel checks in for Jeff Withey. There's a screen by Noel.
No.
Calls right in. He is 8 for 11 with that shot.
And you're starting to see some tired legs on those defenders as we come down the stretch here, Clark.
I mean, at some point, you got to think about subbing some of these guys out, getting them a little bit of a breather. We just can't keep up.
Outside Irving. The pass to the Monster. And stolen by Noel.
All right. That was done.
Smith kicks to Barnes. And here's Smith. Back to Barnes. Over Tatum. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
Let's go.
And Harrison Barnes, just a tremendous athlete at that small forward position. I think his strength enables him to guard up and hold his own.
Right, we're down by one with five left.
For Boston, they've gone 5 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Strong work at that end of the floor. Here's Hayward. Nice teamwork to set up the pick play and make the space for the jam. And Greg, you look at the versatility of Barnes. He can defend, I think, three positions.
And that's what the league is all about now. Switching on picks, much more popular. And with an all-around solid defender like Barnes, it doesn't uncover mismatches.
Irving passes to the Monster. Barnes grabs the miss.
Oh my. What do I gotta do, man? Why am I missing freaking layups?
Smith outside. And he's good on the three ball. And the Mavericks lead by two.
Let's go.
And after a scoreless first half, you're starting to see signs of life here in the second.
Inside, here's the monster. The basket good off the assist from Hayward.
Come on, man.
And that's 18 points for the monster.
Beautiful lead pass. The finisher never has to break stride.
Here's Farrell, guarded by Smart. There's a screen by Noel. Farrell kicks to Noel. He dishes it to Smith. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. That one on Horford.
And when you look at Dennis Smith Jr., you aren't blown away by the physicality at first, but he's incredibly gifted for a player his size. Great speed and quickness to blow by defenders.
Dwight Powell's checked in for Dallas. And with Dennis Smith, it isn't just burst of speed. It's his play in the open floor and Greg running end-to-end, which is phenomenal.
Yeah, he also just jumps and finishes at the rim like a shooting guard. He's only probably 6'2", 6'3", but he gets up in the air like a wing player. He's a lot like Derrick Rose was when he burst on the scene.
Freaking way did that guy just do that?
Oh, how about the deft touch right there, guys?
He just guided that ball back up and in. Just a fingertip touch on the ball. They set the pick. Here's Smart. Passes it to the monster. And it's Noel with the rebound.
Oh, that's just a quick move to the 10 and an even quicker reaction by the D to stop.
Here's Farrell, covered by Irving. Farrell passes to Noel. Yep, that one goes. Now it's a six-point Maverick lead.
Still attacking. On, building on this lead coming down the stretch.
Well, what I like about it most is he's doing it efficiently.
Smart dishes to Hayward. Celtics passing it around. Here's the monster. And it's Noel with the rebound. Noel's got his 18th rebound here tonight, all over the place. There's a screen by Noel.
Nope.
And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two. That one on Horford.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
That one is off. And the Mavericks making a change here. Curry's checked in. Good on the second free throw. Now, here is Irving.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
The monster passes to Irving. A pass to Hayward. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. Curry with it. Now guarded by Smart. Offensive rebound. There's Powell. Good work defensively by Horford.
That's what we're talking about in terms of the activity level defensively. You got to protect the rim.
Well, that takes physical ability, good timing. Those two things that he possesses.
And he has the chops for this. Raising the intensity when it matters most.
But he's showing you he wants to close this game out. That's an attitude that he brings and is appreciated by this team.
Gets the three-pointer to fall. Celtics trail by eight. Irving kicks to Smart. Barnes against Hayward. Over Barnes. Again, the miss by Hayward. For Dallas, they've gone 7 of 15 from the floor here in the fourth. Right around 46-47%. Here's a screen by Noel. Curry on the wing. Powell kicks to Noel. Pass to Barnes. Again, and no problem from Powell as he finishes at the rim, and it's a 10-point Maverick lead. Tries it from the top of the key. That one wide left.
D a little slow to get in his face. They're fortunate it didn't cost him.
And at this point, just sort of running through the paces, as it appears it'll be a nice win here for the Mavericks.
Their hard work on the glass paid off.
I tell you what, they're both.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about right there. Right there.
us hyped after that slam. Smart, giving us some entertainment.
Now here's Curry, guarded by Smart. Noel sets a screen for Curry. Down low. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. That's his second personal. Shooting for Dallas. He drops the first one, and that will put them up by nine. So we see the Mavericks get the win here. This was a very strong showing for him, Greg. Not necessarily.
Had a good first half. Terrible second half. Rebounds. 13 in the first half. The NBA presented by 2K Sports. And we'll see you next time. Overall, pretty good game, but.
So when you gonna get yours up?
Hey, Rook got jokes.
All right, that is gonna be it for this episode. If you liked the episode, leave a like. If you haven't yet subscribed, I'd appreciate it if you would, and we will check out that phone call or that text message the next time on a new Plays NBA 2K18. Have a good evening. Bye.